are you doing here?
Nothing. I wanted to talk to Petra, but sounds like she's busy, so I'll come back.
What's going on up here?
Nothing.
She was spying on you.
I wasn't.
Mind your business, Temp. And get me a water. I'm parched.
I bet.
Are you alone in here?
Well, if you must know, JR and I were just having FaceTime sex. Ooh. Because out of the blue, a job opportunity came up, but it's in Houston.
Houston?
Yes. It's in immigration, and I'm really happy for her.
Of course you are. Then again, Houston is pretty far away.
No, people make long-distance work all the time.
Come on, Petra.
Okay, fine, I'm terrified of what'll happen, but I can't stand in the way of her happiness.
Has JR looked for immigration jobs in Miami?
I don't know.
It's worth a conversation. Speaking of jobs, can I have nights off for the next 2 weeks? I need more writing time.
Yeah, sure. How's the telenovela going?
It's definitely out there.
Jane was finally able to put the pieces of her novel together. See, as soon as she cleared the distractions from her mind, her executive functions began to, well, really function.
Jane, I need to talk to you, and you should lock your front door.
Oh, looks like Jane included Petra in the novel.
Jane!
Oh, my bad.
What's wrong? Sit.
Can I use this rag?
Well, that, my sweatshirt.
JR's taking the job in Houston. She broke up with me. And I feel like someone cut out a piece of my heart.
Oh, Petra.
I'm fine. I should go. I just thought you'd want to know.
Sit your butt back down here. You're not going anywhere.
Okay. Can I sleep here tonight?
Of course. Just give me a second.
I want to hear something really stupid. I was gonna propose.
Oh, no. Hey, it could be a friendship ring. Ah, it's already engraved. Petra and Jane.
Thank you for letting me stay here.
That's what sisters are for.
Aww. If only our story could end there. But this is a telenovela, after all.